district, survivors of the USS Chevalier, and we honor them as we read this. A Psalm of David. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all thy benefits, who forgiveth all thy iniquities, who healeth all thy diseases, who redeemeth thy life from destruction, who crowneth thee with loving kindness and tender mercies, who satisfieth thy mouth with good things, so that thy youth is renewed like the eagles. The Lord executes righteousness and judgment for all that are oppressed. He made known his ways unto Moses, and asked unto the children of Israel. The Lord is merciful and gracious, slow to anger, and plenteous in mercy. He will not always chide, neither will he keep his anger forever. He hath not dealt with us after our sins, nor rewarded us according to our iniquities. For as the heaven is high above the earth, so great is his mercy toward them that fear him. For as far as the east is from the west, so far hath he removed our transgressions from us. Like as a father pitieth his children, so the Lord pitieth them that fear him. For he knoweth our frame. He remembereth that we are dust. As for man, his days are as grass, as a flower of the field, so he follows us. For the wind passeth over it, and it is gone, and the place thereof shall know it no more. But the mercy of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting upon them that fear him, and his righteousness unto children's children. We have a great treat tonight. A Prince and Horace of Wales, post 1506, AFW Melrose, Domek Knopf, Chorus Director, and Jim Fanette, Program Coordinator. And we feel blessed that they come and share with us. And they were asked to come. They're all around busy people. They shared with me that it was entirely unanimous. So the Lord bless you.
Thank you. If there is righteousness in the heart, there will be beauty in the character. If there be beauty in the character, there will be harmony in the home. If there is harmony in the home, there will be order in the nation. When there is order in the nation, there will be peace in the world.
like to think are typical Americans, but they were better than typical. These destroyer men, they were special. They worked and fought and labored in these tin cans and sailed where angels feared to go. We remember them in sadness with pride. We remember you who gave your lives. We have a whole place in our hearts for you who would never change to civilian clothes ever again. We will always be young and alive in our memory.
We thank you for your remembrances, for sacrifices made, for the freedom you gave us, for the courage you revealed, and for commitment to home and heaven.
Hooray! Hooray! Hooray!
dominating this service is one of the crew members of the USS Chevalier. Paul Ryan, bring King Hat. Paul, stand. And the Reverend Emmett Osborne from Greenville, Ohio, chaplain. Shall I call the crew who are here, please stand. All the men who are on that ship. Let's all stand, everyone, and look on the inner bulletin and sing Eternal Father from the city.
Deserving, and I want to say thank you for the men and women and children of my district.
Thank you for coming. And I think we are privileged to have with us this evening the mayor of our city. And I'm prejudiced, I think he's a good mayor. Amen. It's okay to say something good for a politician now and then, you know. Mayor Michael McQuinn. You always have been and you always will be superb. You did an excellent job here. As I was listening to the Princeman, I couldn't help think, if we use all of that energy and people express that kindness throughout the world, there would be no war, conflict, or crisis. To Post 45, the honor guard from our home American Legion, we thank you for always honoring all of our veterans from your inception as the honor guard. To all of our veterans, to our citizens of the community, and to all of the crew members and family members of those who served on Chevalier, I bring you the greetings of the city and welcome you to our community. What an awesome feeling it is for me to stand here, an individual who has so much pride in the fact that Godfrey Chevalier was from our community and for whom this auditorium is named, but to have all of you here, the crew members who have done so much for all of us, not only in the city and state, but in this nation and world in which we live. It is because of you and your brave efforts that today many of us can send our children to the schools of our choice. It is because of you and your brave acts that we can choose our workplace. And it is because of you and your acts of heroism that we can worship in the church of our choice. And we are very proud to have you here in our community this evening. And on behalf of all of us in city government and all of the citizens here, I would like to issue the following proclamation. I would ask Reverend Osborne if he would come forward so I could present it to him. City of Medford, Massachusetts, proclamation. Whereas the destroyer, USS Chevalier, was commissioned by President Franklin D. Roosevelt in August of 1940 in memory of Lieutenant Commander Godfrey Chevalier, a decorated United States Naval officer who was killed in the line of duty in November of 1922. And whereas Lieutenant Commander Chevalier was born in Providence, Rhode Island on March 7, 1889, and as a youth settled on Summit Road in Medford with his family and attended Medford Public School. And whereas Lieutenant Commander Chevalier graduated from the United States Naval Academy in 1910 and immediately distinguished himself by single-handedly rescuing 20 colleagues from drowning in the Hudson River. And in October of 1922, he became the first man to land an airplane on a ship underway. And whereas because of Commander Chevalier's example of gallantry and courage, the city dedicated this auditorium to his memory in November of 1939 as part of the New Medford High School. And whereas the USS Chevalier served our country honorably during World War II, fighting an intense battle and later being sunk by the Japanese Navy in the Solomon Islands on October 6, 1943. And whereas we must never forget those 53 crewmen who were killed defending our country, and we honor the survivors who fought to preserve the freedoms we take for granted today. And whereas in this our centennial year, it is especially fitting for the city of Medford to host this memorial service and reunion for the surviving members of the USS Chevalier, now therefore Ryan Michael J. McGlynn, proclaimed today, October 6, 1992, as a day of remembrance for all of those who served on the USS Chevalier.
This proclamation and it will become a part of
archives of the USS Chevalier. Thank you so much. As I sit in here and looking at Reverend Osborne, your minister, what were your duties on the destroyer?
I was a machinist, thank you.
Machinist, yeah. Okay.
You can go.
We're glad to have with us this evening Chaplain Commander Gary L. Moore, United States Naval Reserve for the Memorial Mass.
The bonding that comes from sharing one another's burdens, have a blood tie that heals the loss on us. And to them, feel this debt. We have sorrow. But you have chosen well, I believe, your scripture for the night. Which speaks not of an end that comes from the loss of life for those who have given up, but it speaks really more of a beginning, of a carrying on, of a God who is sovereign and able, a God who says, consecrate yourself, for tomorrow I will show you great and mighty things which yet you know not. This same God who does not treat us now, nor has he ever, as our sins deserve, but is gracious and kind. Because he knows how we are made, and that we are weak and frail, and that though we have a legacy, even with that legacy, at times we fail and fall short of the standard which he himself has set before us. The Lord has established his own throne, his kingdom, which will not fail. It is he who calls us. The same one who has mighty angels that do his bidding. I guess the question remains, do we have this legacy? Have not shrunk from death. Will we pick it up and still move on? Perhaps you think this is not a fair question, coming from one who, at what it seems like a sea of white hair, had asked the question of you, will you carry on? And you say, well, I've run the course, I've run the race, and yet it is done. I can't go on anymore. It's time for you to go on. And I think not. I think our shipmate, he did not give up until it was over. And I think the same is true for us. We cannot give up. Until it is over, until we go home, for we carry a legacy which this country needs for morality and strength and goodness and purity and righteousness. And if we don't carry that forth, is there? It's worth living for. You've heard of David Livingston. Dan Crawford. He was the man who read Stanley's biography of Livingston and was so moved by it that he went and took his place when Livingston died. And when Dan Crawford died, they found in the flying of his New Testament these words, I cannot do it alone. The waves dash fast and high. The fog comes chill around, and the light goes out of the sky. I know that we too shall win in the end, Jesus and I. Coward and wayward and weak, I change with the changing sky. Today, so strong and brave, tomorrow, too weak to fly. But he never gives up, so we too shall win, Jesus and I. We cannot, we dare not give up. For while the physical war is done, the war for righteousness, the war upon which freedom is based, that is moral integrity and purity, continues on. And we will stand again. generation will pick up the banner and pass it on. And we will keep pure and holy that which God has given us by his good grace until the day we meet him face to face.
Good. McLaughlin. Max Miller. Robert Morris. Woodrow Knoll. Maurice Newman.
Thank you. you have set from everything there is a season, time to be born and time to die, time to plant and a time to pluck up, time to kill and a time to heal, time to get and a time to lose, a time of war and a time of peace. We know you have made everything beautiful in your time. You have given us peace and freedom because these men and many more like them whom we remember today made the supreme sacrifice. May we never forget them and the price they paid for our freedom. Hold them, we pray, forever in the circle of your love.
Share together and talk to them who are dismissed. God bless you.